Touchline here on Y254 Fan Zone. We have been making a lot of noise, not knowing that we are taking a lot of our time for the Fan Zone here today. But we have to talk about some of the matches that will be coming your way this afternoon, with the early kickoff being Sheffield United going against Manchester City. Remember, they have not won any match this season, and this is a team that last season were way up on the top half of the table. Was it a fluke or not? Joining us here, as usual, is also Xavier Mulako. After a very long time, I've not seen him here on the touchline on Y254. Where have you been, man? COVID, what to na konda, una nona.
Been campaigning
You've been campaigning.
Now I'm back.
You're back.
The BBI has brought me back.
BBI? hope your BBI is a safe one. But let's go ahead with the sports one now. Big one there. Sheffield United versus Man City this afternoon. It seems Sheffield lied to us last season, because this season they're not performing at all.
Yeah, it's really taking a toll of them. And then this is the reason of the corona now. Immediately after the corona, the games came up fast and quick. There was no pre-season for most of the teams. Now, if you didn't have a very big squad, you are now in a very tough condition. That's why you can see the Sheffield team, a very small team. Mm-hmm. They do not have the bigger squad now to rotate themselves. They do not have the budget to buy players. Yeah. So it's taking a toll of them. And then when you look at this season, if you cannot do a two-game win or a three or a four win, there's no way you're going to survive. So that's why it's taking a toll on Sheffield. Five games on a loss, there's no way they can come back.
Eric, you have played football.
Yes.
And then Sheffield dependable midfielder John Runderstrom has refused to sign a new contract with the team. Is one of their dependable players from last season coming on to this season. What does that do to the team?
It affects the morale of the team, because if you have one of the people you depend on who has not come up and said that I'm here for the long haul, that in itself is a problem. And eventually the morale of the team goes down.
Yeah.
And the morale of the team will eventually affect or impact on the results.
Okay.
Because signing a new contract ties down that player, inspires confidence in the
players.
And they have to sit down with him and agree.
Yeah.
Yes. And maybe he's thinking of, okay, I want to move on to bigger things.
Yes.
Or holding out for more money.
And now, big one for Man City now, that Manchester City is coming on this side without Sergio Aguero, Fernandinho and Benjamin Mendy. And also Nathaniel Ake and Gabriel Jesus are also 50-50. On to this game. We have seen the way Manchester City has been performing this season. They had a draw against West Ham. If Sheffield go head to head against them, can they also shock Man City this afternoon?
The Manchester City team we have today is not one that I expect is going to get a surprise defeat by Sheffield. Despite that they are away, you realize that one of the key players that has been missing for Manchester City is KDB, Kevin De Bruyne. Given that he might pass a late fitness test to again come into the team, I expect this to be a clean sweep for Manchester City.
Yeah.
So anybody who wants to depend on my prediction can give it a straight win for Manchester City.
For Manchester City. Yeah. Let's go quickly, Eric, to another big game that will be coming later on to the night today. Liverpool-West Ham. West Ham, this season, early stages of this season, have really shocked people. Had a draw against Man City. Last weekend, with Antonio scoring a very good goal, and David Moyes is going against Liverpool. Can it be a shock result?
Difficult game for Liverpool, bearing in mind that Liverpool, they don't have a good centre-back right now, with Van Dijk out. They're leaky, and they've been playing Fabinho. They've been playing Fabinho there. He got an injury, he got a knock. Matip is also injured.
Yes.
So I am sure, if you look at David Moyes, the way he sets up his team, he sets up his team for those long balls.
Uh-huh.
I am sure David Moyes, all the balls will go there. And then they have Antonio.
Yes.
Antonio is a bully in form of a striker who comes in and does a lot.
Yeah.
And David Moyes has a thing for the middle table teams.
Yes.
He works wonders with middle. Look at what he did for Everton before he came to Manchester United.
Yeah.
Today, it will be a tricky afternoon for Liverpool, but yeah. I'm expecting, however tricky it will be, Liverpool will still individual brilliance.
I was waiting for someone to punch you because you have time. But a sensitive player.
And also, because Mikael Antonio is out injured, he got an injury when they played against Manchester City. Mm. Also, you can expect that that is one player that is out of the way, and you realize West Ham without Mikael Antonio, the three games he missed, they lost two. So I think so that is also now going to be a problem for David Moyes.
Yes.
The only problem I have with Liverpool is that all their senior centre backs are out injured. Van Dijk probably out for the season with an anterior cruciate ligament injury, a knee surgery. Joel Matip is also out. So they played makeshift.
Can that be a question injured. For him? How do you feel that?
Liverpool diehard.
Yes, I'll agree. West Ham is a strong team.
Yeah.
I think as a gambler, West Ham have really been misusing my money this season. The Tottenham game, they misused my money. The Man City game, they really misused my money. So they are really strong mentally. But tactically, Liverpool will win the game. Mm-hmm. And we have played with Mascherano as a centre-back in Liverpool. Mm-hmm. So, and also Mascherano played in Barcelona as a centre-back.
Yes.
So Henderson is going to become our new Mascherano. Henceforth. Yes, we are going to convert Henderson to be our centre-back. He's played there before.
What about Fabinho?
Fabinho is out injured.
Alcantara and is always a good defensive midfielder playing in front.
But
attacking.
He's also not fit with an Naby Keita.
But West Ham also, they do not have Antonio, who has banged all the goals for...
Let me ask you a question. Are you not scared that... You won the league. If I'm wrong, please correct me. You won the league courtesy of Van Dijk being the final piece on that chessboard of the Liverpool machinery. Now, he's not there. Fabinho, not there.
We understand. You will say all the Alisson. You'll say Van Dijk. You said.
No. We're just asking.
We want to say that we will be worried once we see a different team. Playing a run of games, winning games.
Yes.
But so far, we are the same with everyone.
Mm-hmm.
We lose one, we win two.
Uh-huh.
Same with other teams. So we are not seeing any consistent team being on our opponents.
Yes. I would like to bust his bubble because last season, they had a run of, by now, they were clear-cut runners up. They had gone.
Uh-huh.
This season, they are with the others.
Mm-hmm.
And... without Van Dijk there this season,
yes,
Liverpool will struggle against teams and big teams.
Also, like the top 10.
Yes,
teams.
They will struggle.
Yeah.
They will struggle. And that's why it makes the Premier League to be very open because, as you said, Van Dijk was consistent. Mm-hmm. He brings calm to the Liverpool defense.
Uh-huh. And that is actually what we have already seen in the season, the few games that we have played. When they were playing Everton and Van Dijk got the nasty injury from Pickford, you realize that they could not catch up with Everton and they ended up actually conceding the equalizer. So from there on, they bring Fabinho in the center back. Away, they played Ajax, I think. And during that game, Fabinho gets out injured, and the only result they could get was a youngster off the bench. I think it was Reyes Williams. And then now it brings them to the reality of the Premier League, that if you are consistent with your defence, again, we saw Adrian is the one who was stepping in for Alisson. Now Alisson was out injured. How many goals have he conceded with Adrian? So many. Now it is a question of Alisson is back. I expect Alisson to start playing today.
Yeah.
But who are you going to field there? You have options. You could make it up.
Please tell him in the next two sentences how they are going to suffer this season.
They are going to be extremely affected. They cannot get Henderson in the centre-back, given that Henderson can hardly keep himself fit.
Yeah.
What other option do you have? You have Milner.
Yeah.
How many games does Milner get in a season?
Robertson plays as a centre-back for Scotland. You can still play Robertson then.
The moment you remove Robertson from the wing-backs, the moment you touch your wing-backs, half of your assists
disappear. We are still unbeaten at... At home, we've never lost at home.
If
Man City is beaten 4-0 by Leicester, Manchester United is beaten by Tottenham, Arsenal is not making any consistent, Chelsea is beaten. Why are you saying you're not going to win the league?
You need to figure you're not out going to win the league. First.
Who is going to win?
You're not going to win the league because we are saying that this.
I need an option who is going to win the league.
Manchester City, Manchester United is there. We are up. We are in there.
Let's finish that conversation because we have got 5 minutes to go. Let's start with. I'm actually now going to throw my running order out. Ask the question. Let's start with you, Eric.
Yes.
Tomorrow, what do you expect between United and Arsenal?
Arsenal will lose tomorrow because United have become unpredictable.
Fadeli, I've not said this.
United have become unpredictable.
Yes.
We don't really know what shape they will come tomorrow.
Uh-huh. Yes. I hope in the they midfield, come with the diamonds.
In the midfield. Mm-hmm. We don't know who starts. Mm-hmm. And if I listen to Solskjaer, the game against Sevilla he lost last time in the semis, of he said he looked at the bench.
Yes.
And there was nobody he could bring up to change the game. This time round against Leipzig, he looked at the bench and he saw options. Cavani, Bruno,
Rashford.
Mm-hmm. So that is what he's going to make. I am still trying to look at the Arsenal team and trying to see who will be able to stop at the pace, the forward pace of Manchester United tomorrow.
Yes.
In their centre-back.
That's the question I've been told to ask.
Yes.
I put it to you. How will the Arsenal defense deal with the United forward line, Marcus Rashford?
Exactly.
They will not be able to deal with us. Look at Marcus. What did he do? Comes off the bench, gets a hat-trick. Mm-hmm. And, you know, by the time Marcus Rashford was announcing his name on the football pitch, which club was he playing against?
Arsenal.
So I expect that to be the repeat tomorrow. So you need a big name for a big name. Marcus Rashford, MBE, will turn up.
Man United and Chelsea are the teams that are playing without, they do not have any philosophy. You do not know what Ole is
the philosophy. They don't know what they are doing.
We do not know what Ole is playing.
Yeah.
You see, that she's saying that we hope he plays a diamond. Because Ole really gazed that game of the RB Leipzig with a diamond and it worked.
But what I will say,
we must agree on that.
What I'll tell you, Sylvia,
that's Ole has a philosophy.
What I'll tell you,
attacking philosophy.
Which
attacking philosophy? The problem with Ole Gunnar.
When it comes to big games, philosophy, formations, form just flows out of the window. You cannot predict. You could look at a match tactically and say, this is a game, bang, 4-4-2. Mm-hmm. Then Arsenal does 4-3-3. Mm-hmm. Or Manchester United will start with a 4-3-3, but then it ends up doing a 5-2-4-5-1.
But we must agree, as a United fan, you do not know what you're going to play tomorrow.
We know what you're going to play. We are going to play attacking football tomorrow. Mm-hmm. The thing we are not sure about, who will start and who will be on the bench.
Yes.
We have a variety of players who can start and who can be on the bench, especially from the midfield upwards.
Tomorrow, you are likely to win. Yes,
we will win.
But there is a only because Aubameyang is not on fire. Aubameyang is really a letdown.
Uh-huh.
And that is why that is the problem in English Premier League, giving players contracts, big contracts. Sometimes they just become a letdown.
Mm-hmm.
So they might win because they're on form.
Yes.
But United are gazing, Chelsea are gazing.
No. You see, when you have very many new players, Xavier, coming in, the coach. The coach will have to experiment with the lineups for him to get the right crop of players he wants.
Yeah.
I'll take you back to Klopp. Since Klopp came in, he has signed 24 players.
Okay.
24 players.
But we must agree. You've only played well in the Champions
before
League.
Before he settled on the front three, there was some time that he had to take.
He had to take some good
Exactly.
Amount
so,
of time.
So it will take time.
Mm-hmm.
But Solskjaer, whether it is fluke or tactics, he has a way of coming up in the big games.
Eric, we have been added 5 minutes and we want to talk about tomorrow's games. Let me just quickly, United Arsenal, what will be your score?
Manchester United 3, Arsenal 1.
Eric?
3-0.
3-0 for Manchester United. Xavier?
Mustafi is on defense. They'll win.
Okay, now let's go ahead and talk about. There's one game that will be happening tomorrow, and that is Newcastle versus Everton. Everton started very well, but they got a shock against Southampton. And now they're going against another troubled mid-table team in Newcastle. Can they bounce back?
What I'm worried about Everton is that against Newcastle, they had a player sent off. Lucas Digne was sent off. They have another player serving suspension.
Against Southampton.
Richarlison is out, serving also for a red card. Uh-huh. We have another player out, James Rodriguez is also out with an injury. Carlo Ancelotti said that he's not going to play against Newcastle. So what they have depended on mostly is Lucas Digne and also Seamus Coleman is out. They have a host of injuries. So I'm worried about the person who's going to supply the long balls to Calvert-Lewin to head them in or to score the goals. So I'm not sure of how they are going to come up, and I'm again worried about the discipline, because if you have a player, each player getting a red card each and every game, then it also tells you that these players need some sort of a discipline check. So with all those injuries, James has been getting assists, has been getting goals, has been getting the secondary assists. So I'm not certain that Everton will get a win against Steve Bruce's men. Yeah. So I'm going to give that to Newcastle.
Eric,
yes.
I want to put you on the spot here. It's a bit of an ambiguous question, but I want to put you on the spot here, because this time round today, it will be match day 7. You look at that top table. It is only Liverpool, who is a traditional top 4 team there. You have Everton, Wolves has made a comeback onto that side. Then you have got teams that are really trying to make it onto the top 6. And can they disrupt the traditional top 4? Because teams like Leeds United are really playing very well. Aston Villa this season has started very well. Is it a time when you might see even teams like Manchester City finishing in number 6 in the table?
No. Mm. After 10, 15 games, the boys will be separated from the men.
Mm-hmm.
And reason being the squad depth, mm-hmm. because the games will come in so many.
Yes.
The squad depth. And when the games become so many, the small teams have a tendency of beginning to garner points the first 10 games for them to secure relegation. They come out of the relegation. Mm-hmm. After that, they start getting whipped.
Yeah.
I'm getting a scenario whereby I'm seeing Aston Villa up there. They'll not be up there match day 15.
Mm-hmm.
I'm seeing Everton, maybe. Mm-hmm. They may be on the top 6.
Yes.
But we will see the Manchester United, the Manchester City, the Liverpool.
Coming to their back to their places.
Places.
Yeah.
Chelsea, when they get it right, they will compete for the top 6.
Yeah.
Maybe a surprise, maybe one team.
Yeah.
Wolves, maybe.
Xavier. Now,
I wouldn't write them as such, because when you see these teams, they've really made some good signings. If you see Newcastle, if you see Aston Villa.
Newcastle, I heard they signed a bricklayer from Australia.
But to talk about Everton, they are really a good side. Only have an issue with their goalkeeper, Pickford. I think they really need to go and look for a goalkeeper.
The issue is personal.
Pickford is a joke, and if England wants to go and
is
win
England
the World Cup,
one?
You cannot win a
Pickford is one of the best goalkeepers in the Premier League.
Let's finish it.
Sylvia has a personal issue with Pickford.
It is
the one who sent Van Dijk out.
Pickford is a joke.
That is where we finish the show here on the Saturday today. It has been fun having this gentleman here and lady here in the studio today. On behalf of everybody who made the Touchline a success, and our new cameraman is a Chelsea fan, we say good afternoon. Enjoy the rest of your viewing here on Y254.